In this video about my CNC version 3.2 series, I will talk about milling motors. I own three of them. The oldest is a 100 watts motor for 12 to 18 volts. The 48 volts 400 watts motor is the only brand new one. And finally the most powerful device with an input power of 900 watts at 230 volts, that is more than a decade old. All motors have a speed control. The 100 watts motor is connected to a 12 volts DC power supply. After turning it on, it runs with maximum speed. And as you can see, the speed control is obviously broken. The maximum revolution speed is rated with 15,000 rounds per minute. The 400 watts motor was delivered with a 48 volts power supply. The insulation of this device is insufficient. The mains voltage runs to metal clamps with a poor enclosure. There is also no additional mount for the mains cable, thus there is no strain relief clamp. 48 volts DC voltage are not dangerous to life, nonetheless a better insulation is desirable at the low voltage end too. The revolution speed is controlled by an external board. Two input clamps can be used to apply a pulse width signal by a microcontroller and so to control the motor speed. If you'd like to set the speed manually, use the potentiometer. You can set a revolution speed that starts at approximately 3000 rounds per minute and goes up to a maximum of 12,000 rounds per minute. Last candidate is the 900 watts device that has an internal speed control same as the low power motor, but this one works. The lowest speed is 8000 rounds per minute. And the range ends at 26,000 rounds per minute. Besides the electrical properties, the mechanical build quality makes a huge difference. The linkage of spindle and CNC mechanics is an important part of the package. The mounts are usually arranged around the neck of the spindles where ball bearings of the motor shaft are placed. The mount of the 400 watts motor is positioned at the motor housing, the neck of this device is simply too small for a mount. The runout is an important factor for the quality of a machine. My measurement setup uses a dial indicator with one scale being 10 micrometers of linear movement. The tip of the indicator touches the 3.175 mm shaft of a 1.5 mm milling cutter. 3.175 mm are 1/8 of an inch. The tip of the dial indicator is placed as close as possible to the collet. There are two ways of mounting the milling cutter on the 100 watts motor. With a self-centering 3 jaw chuck you can mount tools with a shaft diameter from 0.5 to 3.2 mm. The error we get is almost 130 micrometers. The second way of mounting a milling cutter is using an aluminum collet. With that, the inaccuracy is just 100 micrometers. The 3.175 mm collet of the 400 watts motor is made of steel. We get an error of 120 micrometers. Always use the correct collet for your milling cutter. You can squeeze the 3.175mm shaft also in the 3.0mm collet, but that is not recommendable. With that configuration we get an inaccuracy of 190 micrometers. Steel collets are also used for the 900 watts motor. The error of this machine, that is in use for more than a decade, is less than 80 micrometers. During operation, side load is applied to the mechanics. Let's see how the machines bend under side load. The measurement setup uses a lever to push against the shaft of the milling cutter. My kilogram prototype is an old lead acid battery with a mass of 589 grams. With the leverage, the side load is boosted to approximately 19 newtons. The contact point is close to the collet, vis-a-vis to the tip of the dial indicator. We get a deviation of 130 micrometers at the 100 watts motor when using the collet, and almost 200 micrometers with a 3 jaw chuck. The resulting deviation for the 400 watts motor is 60 micrometers. Finally, we get a reading of just 35 micrometers for the 900 watts motor. The rule of thumb is: the higher the electric input power, the more solid the build of the motor. Furthermore, the distance between motor housing and the tip of the collet should be as short as possible. The 900 watts motor is best in all categories. What difference it makes in practice will be examined in a subsequent video. The recorded values and more is listed on the project page. If you'd like to fund more research work, use the donate button on my pages. Thanks a lot to all backers that already made use of that function. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.